Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Welcome again. Welcome again. Welcome again to today's online midweek service. Good to see you connected. Good to see you connected. Good to see you connected. And I want to thank God specially that you are alive. Thank God specially that He has sustained you up to this very moment, irrespective of what is going on all over the world. Hallelujah. So we give God all the praise and all the glory in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Now, today is going to be a special day because we are going to also continue with the subject we started looking at last week. But I trust that God is going to speak powerfully to your hearts, and then, you know, you're going to be touched by the grace of God. I believe strongly your life will not be the same again. Your walk with God is going to receive a boost today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So you get ready, get your friends connected. If you are your household, you are not ready, please tell them to come together and let everybody pick up their, you know, smartphones and get connected, because today is going to be special. Share the page with your friends as well. Okay, just share the page with your friends or your contacts. Let them get to know that the meeting is about to start and that God has something great for us all in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let us pray. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus, immortal and invisible God, the omnipotent, omnipresent, and omniscient, the God who does wonders, yes, the great and mighty God, God of signs and miracles, Father, in your presence we have come. We have come to worship, we have come to seek your face, we have come to learn of you. Father, we have come, mighty God, that we may know you better, we may know how to walk with you, that we may receive wisdom, may receive grace, we may find mercy to help in this season. Father in heaven, I say, take control over today's meeting. Everywhere your children are, wherever they are connected to this meeting, my God, I thank you for your presence is there with them. And I take authority over every place, therefore, and we stand against every satanic activity, interference from the kingdom of darkness over this meeting today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we ask, oh God, that you take charge over the internet, take charge over the Facebook, over every platform, social media, mighty God, Lord, so that there be no interference from the kingdom of darkness concerning this meeting in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father, as you heal the sick today, as you deliver captives, as you raise up, you know, people from, lose them from chains of satanic dominion. Papa, I would say thank you, Lord, for your glory, your light that is going to shine into the lives of your people because the entrance of your word as a teaching brings forth light. We say take all the glory and all the honor for the great and mighty things you've done for us today, Lord. Blessed be your holy and mighty name. In Jesus' wonderful name, I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's take this word of praise. Amen. And bless the Lord our God. Hallelujah. For he is great and mighty. He is great and mighty. Let's look at Psalm, the book of Psalm 145. Psalm 145. Psalm 145. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Psalm 145. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Psalm 145. Amen and amen. Psalm 145. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So we're going to read from verse 1 to the end. That is our praise to God for tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. Let us go. I will extol thee, my God, O King, and I will bless thy name forever and ever. Every day I will bless thee, and I will praise thy name forever and ever. Great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable. One generation shall praise thy works to another, and shall declare thy mighty acts. I will speak of the glorious honor of thy majesty, and of thy wondrous works. And men shall speak of the might of thy terrible acts, and I shall declare thy greatness. They shall abundantly utter the memory of thy great goodness, and sing, and shall sing of thy righteousness. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and of great mercy. The Lord is good to all, and his tender mercies are over all his works. All thy works shall praise thee, O Lord, and thy saints shall bless thee. They shall speak of the glory of thy kingdom and talk of thy power, to make known to the sons of men his mighty acts and the glorious majesty of thy kingdom, Thy kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and thy dominion endureth throughout all generations. The Lord upholdeth all that fall, and raiseth up those that be bowed down. The eyes of all wait upon thee, and thou givest them their meat in due season. Thou openest thy hand, they are satisfied. Thou openest thy hand, satisfy the desire of every living thing. The Lord is righteous in all his ways, and holy in all his works. The Lord is nigh unto them that call upon him, to all that call upon his name in truth. He will fulfill the desire of them that fear him. He also will hear their cry and will save them. The Lord preservereth all them that love him, but all the wicked will he destroy. My mouth shall speak the praise of the Lord, and let all flesh bless his holy name forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. So, Father, we bless your name. We say, Lord, you are worthy of our praise. We'll extol you. Lord, we will magnify your name. Yes, even as you have magnified even your word above all your names. Because, Lord, you are great and mighty. There is no one like you, our God. Father, we say, be exalted above the heavens. Be magnified above the heavens. Above all powers, be thou magnified, our God. Be magnified above all the rulers of the earth. Let your name alone be glorified on the earth, and let your will alone be done, our God. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Blessed be your holy and mighty name, our God. In Jesus' name we worship. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Amen and amen. So we're going to go on to this topic again. That is, what are you seeing or hearing? Last week we said that the picture that you are seeing or you have about God or anything around you or in your mind will either make you afraid and weak, or it will make you bold, confident, and strong. Hallelujah. Faith and fear are two different forces that bring either a positive result or negative result, depending on which of them that is at work. You got that? We settled that all that last week. Now, but it's important for us to know, according to scripture, that faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Very, very important. That is a source of faith. But faith can be encouraged. There are certain things that encourages faith, even though we know there's only one source of faith. Amen. Now, he said faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God, according to scripture. But again, what you see, the things you see, I'm not talking about hearing now, the things you see can stir up confidence or boldness or strength in you as well. The things you see or you hear can set upward confidence, boldness, or strength. Where you were weak, where you were afraid, there are things you see that suddenly gingers you up. You become bold, you become confident. The same way with fear. Fear comes by what you hear or see. But what you hear or see can also stir upward weakness, laziness, and lack of confidence in your life. What you see and hear can also stir up, can make you lazy. Where you were managing to be strong, trying to be strong, there are things you see or hear that suddenly drains the little strength in you. They drain the little confidence in you. Amen. Therefore, as confidence, boldness, and strength are associated with faith, so also weakness, laziness, and lack of confidence are associated with fear. I'm sure you got that. Now, we're going to be looking at some scriptures. For example, because the things that are written, they are for our own example, they are for our own learning. Okay. Now, imagine the 10 spies, those 10 men out of the 12 people 12 men that were sent to spy out the land, the promised land that God promised the children of Israel. You remember the story where Moses sent out 12 men to go spy out the land. The people came back and exhibited fear before the congregation. Why? Because of how they saw themselves as nothing in the eyes of not their enemies, of not the people of the land, but in their own eyes. The picture of themselves, the way they saw themselves before the people of the land, created fear in them. Created fear in them. You understand that? What they saw, the way they looked at themselves, they lost confidence in themselves. Fear came upon them because of the way they considered themselves as compared, the way they considered their own sizes as compared to the sizes of the people of the land. Which means that how you see yourself before or in the presence of other people is very, very important. What we call timidity and shyness is when people begin to feel they are not as good or they feel inadequate in the presence of other people. That is when lack of confidence and shyness come in. That is when fear, when you talk about stage fright, because they have seen themselves as having nothing compared to the audience. So how you see yourself is very important, child of God, in the presence of other people. You are not supposed to see yourself as little. You have who God says you are. In fact, don't see yourself as you because you are nothing. Indeed, see yourself because of who is in you. Amen. The scripture says, greater is he that is in you. So the consciousness, that the picture you are going to be carrying should not be of yourself, but of him that is in you. Numbers 13, verse 25. And they returned from searching the land after 40 days, and they went and came to Moses and to Aaron and to all the congregation of the children of Israel unto the wilderness of Paran, to Kadesh, and brought back word unto them and unto all the congregation, and showed them the fruit of the land. And they told him and said, we came unto the land whither thou sentest us, and surely it floweth with milk and honey, and this is the fruit of it. Nevertheless, the people be strong that dwell in the land, and the cities are walled and are very great. Very great. And moreover, we saw the children of Anak there. The Amalekites dwell in the land of the south, and the Hittites, and the Jebusites, and the Amorites dwell in the mountains, and the Canaanites dwell by the sea, and by the coast of Jordan. Verse 30. And Caleb stilled the people before Moses and said, let's go up at once and possess it, for we are well able to overcome it. Underline that. We're going to come back to this later. Underline that in your Bible, if you can, and I think you should be able to do that. Now, verse 31. But the men that went up with him said, we be not able to go up against the people, for they are stronger than we. I don't know when they did that test. I don't know how they carried out measurement, how they tried out to know that people were stronger than them. I don't know about that. I don't know that. Okay. Now, wait, but they are stronger than we, verse 32, and they brought up an evil report of the land which they had searched unto the children of Israel, saying, the land through which we have gone to search it is a land that eateth up the inhabitants thereof. Ooh, it is strange. If the land eats up the inhabitants, how come the land had not eaten up all the people before they got there? Fear is terrible. Fear will make to conjure things that ordinarily should not be there. He said, they said the land is a land that eateth all the inhabitants thereof, and all the people that we saw in it are men of great stature. And there we saw the giants, the sons of Anak, which come of the giants, and we were in our own sight as grasshoppers, and so we were in their sight. What did they see themselves? How did they see themselves? They saw themselves as grasshoppers before the people. They forgot that Jehovah God, the Almighty God, was with them. Now, hear this. The picture which these 10 men painted, because they were giving a report, the picture they painted in the mind of the congregation through their report made the people weak and became afraid that they began to cry. See what fear does. Fear has torment. That's what the scripture says. It has torment. These people began to torment themselves. They have not even gone to the land. Fear began to torment them that they began to cry. That is because, listen now, that is because the reason they brought that kind of evil report was because they have not wholly or completely followed the Lord to know Him. And that was why it was easy for them to replace. Listen now, they were able to replace the picture of the great and the mighty God who did great wonders and miracles before their eyes. They replaced the image, the picture of God, with a picture of giants and high walls. If they remembered and had the picture of Jehovah, if they were conscious of the ever-present, dwelling presence of God with them, and they had that picture in their mind, there was no way they would have seen themselves as grasshoppers before the people. It would have been the reverse. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Look at number 14. Numbers 14. 1 to 4. And all the congregation lifted up their voice and cried. Why? Because of the picture these people have painted. So in their own mind at that time, the picture they were seeing the picture of dead people. Picture of people being eaten up one after the other by giants. Picture of people being eaten up by the land, because they said the land is a land that swallows up the inhabitants. So they were seeing themselves and were even mourning themselves before they died. They cried and the people wept that night. And all the children of Israel murmured against Moses and against Aaron. And the whole congregation said unto them, would God that we have died in the land of Egypt, or would God we have died in this wilderness? And wherefore had the Lord brought us into this land to fall by the sword, that our wives and our children should be a prey? Were it not better for us to return into Egypt? Can you imagine what fear does? Can you imagine what the picture these 10 people have painted in the mind of the whole congregation? And they said one to another, let us make a captain and let us return unto Egypt. Listen to this. I told you to take note of what verse was that. That was verse 13. Verse 13 in chapter, no, verse 30 in chapter 13. Now, when you look at that statement in verse 30, the scripture says, Caleb steal the people. So we saw the contrary to the report of these 10 men, Caleb was bold to say that they can go up to possess the land immediately, not tomorrow. Let's go up now. He was eager to go because of the picture he was carrying, because of the picture of God, God's presence, which he has come to know that was with them. He said, let us go and possess the land. Why? Because he, Caleb, and Joshua, the scripture said they have wholly, completely followed the Lord. When you wholly or completely follow God, the picture of God you are going to have will not be the picture of a small little God. Because God, in several passages in the scripture, has made himself known to us. He's not a small God. He's the only true and living God. When you carry a picture of the Most High God, you're not going to be afraid before anybody. So they had a picture of that great and mighty God who does wonders and miracles and signs. The Bible tells us that Moses, in the days of Moses, don't forget, the scripture tells us that Joshua was a servant of Moses. And when Moses was going to the tabernacle to meet with the Lord, he went in with Joshua. And many times after communion with God, and he's leaving the tabernacle or the tent, Joshua will not want to go. Joshua wants to stay back to savor the presence of God in the tabernacle. He was not in a hurry to leave. So Moses many times will leave him behind, and he will stay there, savor the presence of God, feel himself. During those processes, he was getting to be filled with the Spirit of the Lord. Caleb also, they followed God. They were determined to know this God, this mighty God, the creator of the universe, who brought them out from the land of Egypt, who parted the waters of the Red Sea, who destroyed Pharaoh, their oppressor. Amen. So, child of God, the picture you need to carry is a picture of God, particularly in this season. You must have a good knowledge, understanding of who the Lord your God is. These are very evil times globally. Is the faith you have in God that is going to sustain you? Is the faith you have in God, the image of God you're carrying, that is going to give you strength in these days of adversity? You should always know that God, the Lord your God, is the Almighty God. He is the Most High God. He is higher than the highest. There is no one higher than him. He is bigger than the biggest. Nothing is bigger than him. He is bigger. Anything you consider to be the biggest, he is bigger than that biggest. The scripture says, he sits in the circle of the earth. And he is in charge over the affairs of the sons of men. The Bible says he rules in the kingdom of men. He is an unchangeable changer. He is able to change any situation without himself being changed. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He has never changed. He will not change because it's your, because the situation concerns you. He cannot change. He will not change tomorrow. He is the one that brings the counsel of the enemy, the counsel of the wicked, to naught, and make their devices, their instruments of destruction, of war, oppression, he makes them of none effect. Know it. He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. He is the King over all the kings of the nation, whether president or prime ministers or whatever. The Lord is the one that rules over them. He is head over them. He lifts up kings. He also brings down kings. He is the God of battles and the man of war. Nobody has ever resisted him and prevailed. Talk more of say succeeding in victory over God. It has never been done. It has never happened. He is a more than able God, able to do all things. The scripture says that with him all things are possible. With your God, with your Father, all things are possible. There is no impossibility with him. Know it. He is the ocean divider. I say he's what the ocean divider. He makes a way where there is no way. Let the enemies lock all the doors, lock all the gates, put all the barricades. When God says he's taking you across, there is nothing that can stop him from taking you across. Listen to me. If the Red Sea could not stop him from taking Israel from Egypt into the promised land, there is no sea, no mountain, no nothing can stop God from taking you to where you are the day that you are going to be. Add the picture of that God, the Almighty God. He's a consuming fire. Not only is he a consuming fire, but it's also a quencher of the flames of fire. He created the fire. He has the power to make the fire fireless. That fire to lose its strength, as he did in the days of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. He is the God that shuts up the mouth of hungry and wild beasts. That's your God. He is the giver of children. He is the one that promotes. Increase comes from him. The Bible says when he opens, no man can shut. And when he shuts, nobody can open. This earth and his fullness, they belong to him. The silver belongs to him, the gold belongs to him. He created all things by himself and for himself. He has power over the storm and over everything. There is nothing that compares with him, whether in strength, in wisdom, in knowledge, in anything. He is the covenant keeping God. He is a promise keeper. When he says he's going to do this, surely he will do it. That thing may not be done in your time, but surely it will be done in his own time. He is a holy and righteous God. Take note of that. Holy and righteous God. You must not fail to see him as a holy and righteous God. He alone is God, the only true and living God. All the gods of the nations, they are things that were created by him. They are dead. The scriptures say they have mouth, but they don't speak. They have eyes, they don't see. They are carved out of wood and stones. They are things that God created, but God is the one that created all those things. He has been from eternity past to eternity to come. He has no beginning, has no end. Any other thing you call God or people call God, they have a beginning and also they have an end. That's the God you have. That's the God we have as our Father. So the picture you have about this God will encourage you, will strengthen you. Even in the face of trouble, will encourage you. You must carry this picture of him whose presence fills the heavens and the earth in your heart and mind. Everywhere you carry that picture of God. Carry that picture in your mind. See him. He said he will never leave you nor forsake you. So seek him inside of you. Seek him beside you. Seek him with you. Look at the scripture. Hear this. Isaiah 43, verse 10, 11, and 16 and 17. He said, you are my witness, saith the Lord, and my servant, whom I have chosen, that you may know and believe, that you may know and believe and understand that I am he. Before me there was no God formed, neither shall there be any after me. I am the Lord, and beside me there is no Savior. Verse 16, thus saith the Lord, which maketh a way in the sea and a path in the mighty waters. That's our God. Which bringeth forth the chariot and horse, and the army and the power, that they shall lie down together, they shall not rise. They are extinct, they are quenched as tow. You see that? They are quenched. He brings kings, he brings horses, he brings chariots, he brings them down, make them to lie down, say they shall not rise. God is able to subdue the enemies. God is able to bring them down that they will never be able to rise up. The only thing, child of God, you should be desired and praying for yourself that you should always be in the good books of God. And don't put yourself in a place where the enemy can get at you. Period. You have a great and mighty God. Carry that picture. Let that picture encourage you. Let it give you confidence. Let it give you faith. Isaiah 40, 15 to 18. Behold, the nations are as a drop of a bucket. The nation, he didn't say one nation. The nations are as counted as the small dust of the balance, that's of the scale. Small dust of a scale. Not even a grain of sand in the scale. Small dust. Behold, he taketh all the eyes as a very little thing. Verse 16. And Lebanon is not sufficient to burn, nor the beast thereof sufficient for burnt offering. All nations before him as nothing, and they are counted to him less than nothing, and vanity. Verse 18. To whom then will you liken God? To whom will you liken God? Or with what likeness will you compare unto him? Nothing compares with your God. Nothing compares with our Father. Nothing. Nothing. Those things that make you afraid, that look so big before your eyes, child of God, turn the picture around. They are nothing before God. They are nothing before God. Look at 40 again, verse 21. And 23 to 23. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Had it not been told you from the beginning? Have you not understood from the foundations of the earth? It is he that seated upon the circle of the earth, and the inhabitants thereof are as what? Grasshoppers. Man, this is what nails it. What drives that, what, like they say, hitting the nail on the head. It says what? And the inhabitants of the nations as what? Grasshoppers. Instead of the 10 spies to see the inhabitants of the land as grasshoppers, the way God sees them, they saw themselves as the grasshoppers. Look at it. No, look at it. Kaderon. People carrying Jehovah, carrying the Most High God, the Almighty God that was with them. They were the ones seeing themselves as grasshoppers before grasshoppers. He said, the inhabitants, therefore, as grasshoppers, that stretcheth out the heavens as a curtain. This is God. And spreadeth them out as a curtain to dwelling, that bringeth the princes to nothing. That bringeth the princes to nothing. He maketh the judges of the earth as vanity. The judges of the earth. He makes them as vanity. If only men can understand who the Lord we are talking about is. If only president and prime ministers, head of states, if only they can know that there is a God that rules in the kingdom of men. This is God that drove Nebuchadnezzar, the whole king, into the wilderness. If you have killed Nebuchadnezzar, then of course Nebuchadnezzar will not have he will not have the time to honor God. But I thank the Lord he didn't kill Nebuchadnezzar. He drove him, a whole king, with all his majesty, drove him into the wilderness. That the whole king for 7 good years was eating grass like an animal. Wet with dew of heaven, nobody could deliver him out of the hands of God. He had children, he had family members, he had magicians, he had sorcerers, he had doctors in the land, but nobody could save you. Nobody can save you out of the hand when God is angry with you or when the hand of God is against you. That's the God you have as your father. That is why you must have that picture of God. Have the picture of God that drove Nebuchadnezzar. Say, Nebuchadnezzar, yeah, come on. Get into the wilderness and begin to eat grass like an animal. You get that? So don't let any Nebuchadnezzar frighten you. Don't let any Nebuchadnezzar threaten your life. Don't let any Pharaoh threaten your life. Don't let any Sennacherib threaten your life. Don't let any Og threaten your life. Don't let any Sihon threaten your life. Don't let any Goliath threaten your life. The little David, he knew his God. Because of the picture he had about God giving him victory over the land of the dead, he took that picture to the war to contend with a trained, skilled soldier called Goliath, a giant. But the Lord God gave him victory over the giant. Meanwhile, his brothers and the rich men that were trained to be soldiers were frightened when they saw Goliath, when they saw the height of Goliath and all the weapons of war that Goliath was carrying. They were crying and shivering. Meanwhile, a little boy that had a proper picture of Jehovah, the Most High God, the God of battles, came with just catapults and stones and destroyed Goliath in the presence of a fearful group of people who had no image or picture of the Lord God that they had in their midst. Child of God, it's unfortunate that instead of those 10 spies to see the people of the land as grasshoppers, instead of them to be doing and say, these people are grasshoppers, they were looking at themselves as grasshoppers. May you not see yourself as a grasshopper before the enemy. May you not see yourself as a grasshopper before the grasshoppers. You get that? May you not see yourself as a grasshopper before anybody. Huh? See yourself. See God in you. See God in you. See God in you. See God with you. 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 6 to 10. He said, the Lord killeth, the Lord maketh alive. This is our God. We just need to get to know who this our God is. He's the one that kills, he's the one that gives life. He's the only one that gives life. The Lord will give you life. You will not die. Coronavirus will not kill you. You shall live. And by the grace of God, the Lord fill your body, your organs, yourself with life because he gives life. He bring that down to the grave. He bring it up. That which is dead in your body, in your life, may they receive life now by the grace of God. May they come up alive in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Lord make it poor and make it rich. He bring that low and lifts it up. He lifts up. So don't bother where you are. God is lifting you up. Don't be afraid to fall. You will not remain on the ground. God will surely lift you up. He He raised up the poor out of the dust. And lifted up the beggar from the dunghill to set them among princes and to make them to inherit the throne of glory. That is our God. How poor are you? Have you eaten from a waste bin? Even if you have been eating from a waste bin, your time of lifting up has come. God is lifting you up. He has done it before. He's able to do it again, and he's doing it. Now is your time. You are the next miracle. I say you are the next kind of the miracle of God. Begin to see the hand of God taking you out of that situation. Begin to see the hand of God lifting you up. See God lifting you up. Hallelujah. Lifting you up to sit where? With princes. With princes. People that you have looked up to before, that these are the big men, these are the whatever you may call them. You are joining them now. I say you are joining them now. God is taking you up there. I say God is taking you up there. God is taking you up there by the grace of God. Hallelujah. The pillars of the earth are the Lord's, and he has set the word upon them, the word upon them, the pillars of this earth. Meanwhile, this earth, listen to me, child of God, this earth is in space. We are all sitting on the earth. You are not feeling any tremor. You are not feeling any shaking. Remember, this earth is rotating. It's moving around on its axis and turning around the sun. You are not feeling it. You can't see any thread. You can't see any rope holding it. The scripture says the pillars, there are pillars holding the earth. Science may tell us that it's a centrifugal force that is pulling the earth and the planets together. But listen to me, child of God. The scripture says, of course, this comes also to explain to us, child of God, the question of knowing how the shape of the earth should be settled. He said God sits in the circle of the earth. That tells you that the earth is secular. The earth is secular. Whatever somebody else says is immaterial to me. God said he sits in the circle of the earth. And the pillars of the earth are the Lord's. He has set the word upon them. He keepeth the feet of his saints. Are you a saint of God? Are you a child of God? God is keeping your feet. Your feet will not be broken. Your feet will not be broken. I say your feet will not be broken. He keepeth the feet of his saints. You will not fall, child of God. And the wicked shall be kept silent in darkness. Your enemies shall be kept silent in darkness. See the picture of God shutting up the mouth of your enemies and those who hate you, who are speaking evil against your life. God himself says to you, any tongue that will rise against you in judgment, you condemn. He has given you that power. The great and mighty God has given that power and authority. Shut them up. For by strength shall no man prevail. You see that? Those who think they are very strong, God said by strength shall not prevail. There's no amount of weapon that we have. When God said, listen to me, you are going to die today, with all their weapons, they will die. For by strength shall no man prevail. The adversaries of the Lord shall be broken to pieces. Out of heaven shall be thunder upon them. The Lord shall judge the ends of the earth, and he shall give strength unto his king, and exalt the horn of his anointed. Are you an anointed of the Lord? The Lord will exalt your horn, your strength, your power. Hallelujah. So receive that strength. Receive that exaltation. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. That's what God is doing in your life right now. Strengthening your horns, your power. Hallelujah. Child of God, you have no choice. Let me say to you again, you have no choice. Listen, I say again, you have no choice. You have no choice but to know the Lord your God. You must know the Lord your God. I'm not just talking about knowing him to survive. I'm not talking about knowing him to survive this economic crisis, overcome the plans of the enemies, or the counsel of the devils concerning your life. No, I'm not just talking about surviving. You will survive. God has sustained you. God has sustained you. Just believe God that nothing will happen to you. You will see the end of this pandemic. You will see the end of every global crisis. You will see that end. They will not see your end by the grace of God. No matter how you are feeling right now, God will keep you alive. So you are not just going to be survived. God is not just going to sustain you to keep you alive, but child of God, your desire should be to know him, to live for him, and to do exploit for the kingdom of our God. Don't just plan, I'm going to live and not die. To do what? No. But to live for God, to do exploits. Hallelujah. Your living on the earth should not be useless to God. It should be useful to the kingdom of our God. Daniel chapter 11, verse 32. He said, and as such as do wickedly against the covenants are he corrupt by flatteries. But the people that do know their God shall be strong and do exploits. When you know him, you carry the picture. You can't just know him and be there. What you know, the picture of what you know should be there. Carry that picture of God, the Almighty God, the great and mighty, the greater one that is in you. Carry that picture, and that will enable you to do exploits. You will not fear. You will not chicken out in the face of trouble. You will not chicken out in the face of battle. We must follow God. Look at the scripture. He said, Caleb, wholly follow the Lord. We must wholly, that is completely, wholeheartedly, know God like Joshua and Caleb, and also go about with that consciousness of his ever-abiding presence with us and in us. You see, there's a difference between us and Joshua and Caleb. In their days, God was only with them. But for us, we have a greater advantage in that God is not only with us, but is inside of us. He said, I will dwell in you. I will walk in you. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. So don't see yourself as an ordinary person. You are not yourself. There's God inside of you. See God in you. See God in you. And because of the presence of God, the Almighty God in you, don't see yourself as little. Don't see yourself as a nobody. You are somebody because God is in you. It is not because of you, but because of the God that is in you. That is why you are somebody. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Numbers 14, 5 to 10. Then Moses and Aaron fell on their faces before all the assembly of the congregation of the children of Israel, and Joshua, the son of Nun, and Caleb, the son of Jephunneh, which were of them that set the land, the two, rent their clothes when all those were giving evil report and making the people cry. They rent their clothes and they speak unto the company of the children of Israel, saying, the land which we pass through to search it is an exceeding good land. If the Lord delight in us, praise the name of the Lord. That should be what you be considering. If the Lord should delight in me, and may the Lord delight in us, may the Lord delight in you, child of God. If the Lord delight in us, then he will bring us into this land and give it to us, a land which floweth with milk and honey. Only rebel not. Rebel not ye against the Lord. Don't rebel against the Lord. Deal with that rebellious spirit in your life. Deal with that Lord disobedience in your life. God is not the man that he should lie. There is nothing impossible with God. God is able to help you. Only put yourself in the place where God can help you. God is in the life of people, Christians that have died, whether in accident or whatever, from sickness. Don't put yourself in the place where God will fold his hand in a very bad situation concerning you. He said, when the enemy shall come like a flood, the Son of God will raise a standard. Don't grieve the Holy Spirit, child of God, that the Holy Spirit will not raise a standard against your enemies. If the Lord delight in us, child of God, if the Lord delight in you, then he will bring us into this land and give it to us, a land for flow of milk and honey. Only rebel you not against the Lord, neither you fear the people of the land, for they are bread for us. Do you see that? That is what a good picture of God should do for you. They are bread. They should be the grasshopper, not you the grasshopper. They are bread for us. Their defense is departed from themselves. Amen. Amen. Their defense is departed from them. And the Lord is with us. You see the picture? The Lord is with us. Say the Lord is with me. Say the Lord is in me. Say greater is he that is in me than all my enemies that are out there in the world. Than all of them that hate me in the world. Than all of them that are opposing me in the world. Than all of them that are fighting me in the world. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. He said, and the Lord is with us. Fear them not. Therefore, don't fear the enemy, whether they are principal or powers, whether they are witches or wizards, whether they are marine devils, whether they are queens or kings or princes. Don't fear them. Greater is he that is with you and in you than they that are in the world. In the first instance, God didn't say they will not come against you. He said, surely they will come against you, but not by him, not by his permission. Any power of darkness, anybody that will come against you, God said they shall fight for your sake. And indeed they shall fall for our sake. Not by our power, not by my, but by the Spirit of the Lord they shall fall and be destroyed in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Verse 10. Thank you, Jesus. But all the congregation based stone them with stones. You see, those who are afraid. And the glory of the Lord appeared in the tabernacle of the congregation before all the children of Israel. Child of God, don't be like the 10. Be like, that's why we say, don't follow the majority. People later want to follow the crowd. They say the crowd is there, crowd is there. Sometimes the crowd don't mean anything. Only 2 out of 12 crowd made the people cry. Only 2 have faith in God. Only 2 carry the proper picture of God with them. Don't follow the crowd. Don't join the crowd. The world says the majority carries the vote. No, but he that is with God carries the vote. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. If you have never experienced the power of God in your life, to have an image of that God that delivered you, child of God, read the scriptures. You see what God has done in the past, and let the picture of that great and mighty God that did those miracles carry that picture of God to help you. To help you. Be with people that have testimonies in their life. They will stir up your faith. Because the God that did for them will also do for you. Thank you, Lord. Look at this, because the presence of God will always bring confidence. Here in 1 Samuel chapter 4, he said that when the ark of the covenant of God was, which was symbolic of the presence of God in the midst of his people, okay, came into the camp, the people became what? Confident and encouraged and strengthened and shouted with a great shout. Look at first Samuel chapter 4. Look at verses 3. We're going to read verses 3 to 6. He said, and when the people were come into the camp, okay, the elders of Israel said, wherefore had the Lord smitten us? There was war between Israel and the Philistines. Okay. Wherefore had the Lord smitten us today before the Philistines? Let us fetch the ark of the covenant of the Lord out of Shiloh unto us. Did you hear what they said? They know that the ark was a symbolic representation of the presence of God. So when the ark comes, they know that God has come. So in the day of battle, the ark was not with them. So they felt that because the ark was not with them, God was not with them. So let them go get God. Let them go get God. Let them go get God. So let's fetch the ark or the covenant of the Lord out of Shiloh unto us, that when he cometh amongst us, it may save us out of the hand of our enemies. So the people sent to Shiloh, that they might bring thence the ark of the covenant of the Lord of hosts, who dwelleth between the cherubims, and the 2 sons of Eli, Hophni and Phinehas, were there with the ark of the covenant of God. And when the ark of the covenant, verse 5 now, and when the ark of the covenant of the Lord came into the camp, all Israel shouted with a great shout, so that the earth rang again. Oof! I can just see a picture of great shouts. You know, like some of you are footballers, when your team scores, you know the way the stadium rings. Shout, joy, jubilation. Or when maybe on the final day, the final match, you know, your team wins, the nation cup, a team wins, you know, look at the way the whole nation jumps into jubilation, stress, everybody shout. That was how the children of Israel shouted, because they know that the Ark of the Covenant was the symbolic representation of God, God's presence in their midst. So for them, God has come in. Now that God has come in, woo! Champion has come in. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. See God in your life. See God. See God. See God. See God. God is not going on holidays. He said he will never leave you nor forsake you. That is why you should always be joyful. That is not the reason why he said, rejoice. And again, I say to you, rejoice. 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 For the Lord is near. The Lord is near. The Lord is near. The Lord is near. It's in you, it's there. God is with you. Rejoice. Shout for joy. Don't be afraid. Carry that picture of God, the Most High God, the man of war, the man of war, the God of battles. Seek him. Seek him to rise up in his anger against the wrath of your enemies and to fight against them that fight against you. He has said he will fight against them that fight against you. He said he will beat down your enemy and plague them that hate you. He said he will cause your enemy to be fed with their own flesh and be made drunken with their own blood as a sweet wine. He said he will save your children. He said no weapon formed against you by any creature he created and carried by anybody, any creature he created against you shall prosper. That's the promise of God to you. Why? Because your righteousness is of him, not of yourself. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. And when the Philistines heard this noise of the shout, they said, what meaneth the noise of this great shout in the camp of the Hebrews? And they understood that the ark of the Lord was coming to the camp. Your shouting alone, look at it now. Your bold face alone, because of the picture of God you are carrying, can make your enemy afraid. That is it. So what is giving this guy this kind of boldness? I mean, it's God that is with me. I'm not alone. God is with me. What is giving this kind of confidence? Well, it's God that is in me. I know the God that is with me. The more than able God. I'm not afraid. A thousand shall fall on my side, 10,000 on my right hand. They shall not come near me. For the Lord hath promised not to forsake me nor leave me. Not even in this time, difficult time, I will not forsake you. May he never forsake you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Child of God, begin to seek God in your situation. I say begin to seek God in your situation right now. Begin to have a picture of him. Begin to seek him in that situation where you are. In this particular situation over the world, begin to seek God. Seek him in your life. Seek him with you. Seek him inside of you and be made strong. Receive strength as you begin to see him. Receive confidence as you begin to see him. Remove that garment of weakness and sorrow off you as you begin to see that God is at work in you. Don't be intimidated. Don't be shy before anybody. The one that is in you and with you is greater than the richest person on the face of this earth. Amen. And so don't let anybody intimidate you. You are a child of the great and mighty God who have promised never to leave you nor forsake you. He is with you wherever you are. Only don't do anything that will make you to keep quiet, because God can keep quiet in the presence of evil. Make him to delight in you. Caleb said, if only the Lord delights in us, make God to delight in you. Child of God, seek righteousness and don't give any room to the enemy in your life. Seek righteousness. He says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Pursue after righteousness, child of God. Pursue after righteousness. Keep away from idolatry. Keep away from evil. Because God, our Father, is a holy God. Remember, he's a holy God. The Bible says the righteous, they are as bold as what a lion. The word says the guilty, they are what? They are afraid. So if you don't live a life that is not consistent, if you live a life that is not consistent with the will of God, then you are bound to be afraid. But if you are living a life that is consistent with the will of God, child of God, and then you know that your righteousness is not by your works, then you have every reason to be bold. is wanting to be bold, is wanting to obtain favor before God, is one another thing to God to delight in your action. God loves the sinner, take note, but he hates sin. So if you live in sin, even if you are confessing the righteousness of God, you're on your own. O-Y-O, on your own. Don't be afraid, child of God. God is with us. Emmanuel, the Lord is with us. He's in us. Hallelujah. Don't be afraid. You will survive this pandemic. In fact, you have overcome it. Jesus Christ said, "What? Be cheerful. I have overcome the world." Let me ask you, is it pandemic? Is it in the heaven or here on this earth, in this world? If it's in the world, Jesus has overcome it for us. The global crisis, is it in the heaven, eternity, or here in this world? It's in this world. Jesus has overcome it for us. Hallelujah. So God will sustain us. He that promised to sustain us will sustain, will keep us, will keep you. Hallelujah. So you will not die. You will live. You will make it. You will laugh again. Hallelujah. And by the grace of God, you will testify of the goodness of the Lord to the glory and honor of the Lord. You will testify. I say you will live to testify. You will live to testify. For the Lord will turn your captivity again. Amen. Amen. I said you will testify. So don't be moved. Just see the picture of yourself out of this trouble, out of that trouble. Job said, even though once it is body, yet in that body he will see God. See God in that body. See God. See the glory of God in your life. Hallelujah. And as you begin to see the glory of God, may they begin to manifest. May they begin to manifest. May they begin to manifest. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, child of God, this is the word of God for us tonight. Amen. This is the word of God for you today. So, whatever you are seeing that is contrary to the good picture of the Lord God, change that picture and begin to see God. If you are seeing a negative picture, if you are carrying a negative image, change it. The picture, right in your mind, change. Begin to see God. Any pictures that has come to show you, whether in the dream, all those nightmares, change the picture, cancel it in the spirit. Say, I cancel every negative picture image that the enemy showed me. I change it by the grace of God. I see the glory of God. I see the beauty of the Lord. I see life. I see success. I see victory. I see my enemies destroyed. I see the wicked destroyed. In the name of Jesus, and so shall you see them in the natural, and so shall it come to pass in your life. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. If you have listened to this message and not given your life to Jesus Christ, better do so now. Because the promises are for the children of God, children of the covenant. And the only way you can come into the covenant is through Jesus Christ, who died for you because he loves you. Ask him to come now. Every satanic activity around you, around us, I command them to see that the Lord return the curse back to the sender. Because he said, we curse them that curse us. Whatever the enemy is directing over you against us at this moment, I command them to return back to the sender. That's what you say. Everything directed against me in the name of, I command you back to your sender. And go and destroy those that sent you. And you and them be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So say to me, say with me now, Almighty God, I thank you for your word I've heard today. I believe Jesus Christ died for me, a sinner. And I ask you, Jesus, to come into my life and save me. Wash me with your blood. I receive you today as my Lord and my Savior. And I thank you for saving me. Thank you for taking away my sins and giving me your righteousness. I declare and I confess I'm the righteousness of God now. I declare and I confess I'm child of God now. I declare and I confess I'm born again now. Heaven is my home. And it's not the kingdom of heaven. I'm a member of the household of God now, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, thank you for accepting me to that as your son. Every promise you have for your children, I receive my portion. I am a partaker of the promise of the living God for his children in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. And child of God, I pray for you that whatever you are seeing that is of God, may the blood of God wipe out that evil image from your mind. I say, may the blood of God wipe out that evil image. May the Lord cause you to begin to behold great and mighty and wonderful and beautiful things in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And every power of darkness that's opposing you, causing you to see that which is negative in order to put in a state of fear and trouble, the Lord rebuke and destroy them on your behalf in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I speak peace of God upon your life. I speak life upon you. I speak grace of God upon you. You shall live and you shall not die. You are out of this trouble. You are out of that trouble. You are out of that situation. The Lord lift you up. The Lord make a way for you. The Lord cause the glory of the Lord to be seen upon you. And may the name of the Lord be glorified in your life. May the Lord put laughter in your mouth. May you be the next testifier of the goodness and the glory and the kindness and the grace of God in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, take all the glory and all the honor. Thank you for what you have done today. Thank you for healing the sick. Thank you for raising the oppressed. Thank you for quickening those whose bodies are sick, Lord. Father, Lord, I say thank you in the mighty name of God for yokes of the devil are destroyed from the lives of your sons and daughters. Blessed be your holy and mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. So thank God that you made it today. Thank God for being, thank you also for being part of the service today. Hallelujah. All that the Lord has done in your life, I pray that it be permanent in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And everything you are standing and believing God for, I join faith with you and I believe and as I pray, they shall come into manifestation and the God our Father shall be glorified in your life in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Amen. So please, as you have come to the end of the service today, we are meeting again on Sunday. We have not been streaming our services, but by the grace of God, I believe we're going to do so this coming Sunday, by the grace of God. Hallelujah. God is speaking to us. And the title of the message, God began to say to us this Sunday. What was the title of the message again? Let me see. Who is your role model? Who is your role model? Very powerful message. Who is your role model? Very powerful. Very, very powerful. So I would like you to be part of it. So look forward to it. Make sure you click those buttons, you know, a notification button, you know, so that you'll be reminded. Amen. And please, make your comments. Let us know how God has touched and blessed you in this meeting, okay? And God will bless you, and those things that God you have believed God for, they will really come into manifestation. So on Sunday by 9 a.m. West African time or Nigerian time, we'll be online, and then those of you who live in Lagos, who are around us, you can find your way to 114 Old Ojo Road, you know, Grace for All Ministry, that's the place. We just beside the police station and then Open Access Bank PLC. You won't find it difficult to locate at all. Old Ojo Road is in Pesach Axis. Hallelujah. God bless you as we look forward to seeing you. Of course, don't forget we are doing, when you're coming, come with your mask. We are still doing social distance. We have three services. First service starts 8:30 a.m. in the morning, and then it ends by 10 a.m. And then the second service starts at that time, actually to 9:50, because second service will now start by 10 a.m. and then end by 11:30. Okay, third service starts at that time and ends another one and a half hours time also. So we look forward to seeing you, you know, in person if you are in Lagos, but otherwise, for the sake of those of you who are somewhere in other parts of the world, we look forward to seeing you connected with us online. And I believe God has something for you, and it shall be blessed in Jesus' mighty name. We are meeting again on Wednesday next coming week, and I believe God is going to have something powerful for us as well. So God bless you. Don't forget, you can reach us on this number, you know, +234, plus that's Nigerian code, +234-802-909-2736. Send text message only, text messages only. Or +234-803-307-7334. Okay? Text messages only. Share with us what God is doing in your life and what He has done. If you have any prayer points, you know, you have anything to be prayed for, don't forget you can send them by text message, and then we'll pray with you. And I believe that God answers prayers. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I look forward to seeing you again. And until then, stay blessed. and stay rapturable in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God bless you and stay safe. Amen.